It's a new day. Yes, it is.
The following six-man contest is a tag team match, and it is set for one fall. On the way to the ring, the WWE Tag Team Champion, Xavier Woods, Kofi Kingston, and Big E. The New Day.
Listen to this arena.
Plenty of combustible elements involved in the six-man tag team match. Look out.
It's hard not to get excited when Xavier Woods is in the ring. His energy is so contagious.
Yeah, it's party time, Cole. Come on, get up, show off some of those dance moves. Uh-oh. No, you look silly. Xavier Woods is just so dangerous. This match has swayed his way very quickly here.
Let's get your thoughts here on Sheamus. If you want to know where Xavier Woods' energy, drive, and determination come from, try this on. Xavier says he was born in a barrel of butcher knives and raised in a forest of fire.
Ouch. What that saying means for our viewers at home is Xavier is double tough. He's been through a lifetime of adversity and came out on top.
Well, luckily, the body hasn't absorbed too much of an attack up to this point.
And it's Xavier Woods executing the reversal. Oh, out of nowhere!
Ouch! After a move like that, he's gonna need to see a chiropractor or a spine specialist, whatever he's comfortable with. No pun intended, of course.
Yeah, he's not gonna be comfortable for a while. Oh no! Barrett with the opportunity!
Xavier Woods enters the ring with the energy of an entire Survivor Series team roster. Woods feels the funk alongside the Funkadactyls and moves the crowd when he flies solo or with his main man, R-Truth. If you don't know by now, funk is on a roll. And if you get dropped by Xavier Woods, you're going to need to call your mama.
Not today, too fast.
Three.
Xavier Woods making his statement as we speak.
Well, out here, you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you can find yourself in a world of hurt.
Five.
He's too good inside the ring to be out on the floor for long.
I don't agree with you, Kink.
Hey, Xavier Woods shows some clever offense here.
He gets the tag.
Xavier Woods is a non-stop dance party. And to be fair to his opponents or fans, where Xavier's dance moves are just too much to handle, he does warn everyone in his entrance song when he says, it's about to get funky up in here. But you gotta love it, because funk is on a roll. Get at him, Xavier.
No way. The referee never even saw it. I mean, this is crazy.
How do you miss something like that?
This is a wreck. He's moving like an uncaged animal.
No lie. He's wild in there.
And more brutality here.
Oh, my gosh. I never thought I'd say this, but Bad News Barrett might be out cold.
These competitors will always be looking to unleash their finishing maneuver, and when that happens, the complexion of the match can change in a heartbeat.
You're right about that. The entire match can end in a heartbeat if somebody hits their big move. You know, Bad News Barrett has had some memorable moments here in WWE. He won the first season of NXT. He led the evil group called Nexus. He's been in the core, and he's been an Intercontinental Champion. Barrett's been roughing up WWE's favorite heroes, and now he's handing out bad news. And he's just getting started.
And what a reversal from Barrett.
Oh, no. Wait a minute, Cole. What's he going to do here?
Rusev is tagged in.
To avoid that. And now he's back out on the apron.
Can you get quite the overview earlier of Bad News Barrett's tenure here in WWE? Barrett's led factions, been a champion, has remained one of WWE's most loathsome villains, which the British Bruiser is quite proud of, by the way.
Yeah, well, listen, Cole, when you're a former bare knuckles champion like Bad News Barrett, you're going to attack everything and everyone with no regard for rules or an opponent's well-being. And that's the good news.
Wow, that overhand punch started down behind his feet and just kept coming.
Oh, man, that came out of left field.
Not today, too fast.
He gets the tag.
Hey, and if you guys need proof of exactly how unstoppable Bad News Barrett has been over the years, just check out his trophy case. There's a lot of Intercontinental Championships in there. Oh!
Going for the cover. Giving Xavier Woods a chance to recover. Smart.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
These guys are giving it their all here tonight, not just to entertain the fans, but to ultimately walk away with the win.
And he finally gets out of the ring.
Sheamus is a superstar. He's broken a lot of barriers and a lot of skulls, King. But the one barrier he's proudest to break is being the first Irish-born champion in WWE history.
Well, that's right, Cole. The Celtic Warrior came straight from the old country holding a big old four-leaf clover. But there was no luck involved the way Sheamus won his first title. It was pure guts. He took the championship off none other than John Cena at Tables, Ladders, and Chairs in his rookie year in 2009. Now that was as quick a climb to the top of WWE as you're going to see.
Folks, we're coming to you from Dallas, Texas, and we're just a few short miles from Reunion Boulevard, where one of the most historic buildings in wrestling history once stood. As prestigious and groundbreaking as that first WWE championship may have been for Sheamus, his World Heavyweight Championship win in 2012 was no less of an achievement. It came on the grandest stage of them all at WrestleMania 28 against
Great Counter, really pushing his opponent to the limit here.
Boy,
Did he get dropped or what?
Big E looking for the pin.
Two.
Great job by the official here tonight. I don't know how he's managed to keep so many larger-than-life competitors in check here. He may be in the best.
Great counter. Not today, too fast.
And you talk about Sheamus' World Heavyweight Championship at WrestleMania 28. What made that win over Daniel Bryan even more momentous was the fact that the Celtic Warrior did it in an unbelievable 18 seconds. I mean, Sheamus won the title in less time than it takes you, Cole, to put on your socks in the morning.
Look out!
Look out!
Xavier Woods tagged in.
Boy, there's no way he's going to be able to...
An early pin attempt.
Come on, Rip, count!
He's simply reminding him that he's here. My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe. Somehow, he's kicked it into another gear here tonight. You know, I think the best way to describe Xavier Woods' offense would be a whirlwind. Woods just explodes with Monte Fisto. It's the Monte Fisto.
Look at it, catch him off guard. Competing at full health here, definitely in a good position.
And now, Rusev pushing forward. It is so hard to stop that kind of strength.
Back is the largest area on the human body, and thus, always a target.
I know what you mean. You know, I've got a weak back.
How long did you have that?
About a weak back.
In a relatively brief period of time here in WWE, Xavier Woods has become known all over the Mexico. A bit of contempt coming through on that slam.
What a display of power that was. If he keeps up this pace, this could turn real ugly, real fast.
From Rusev. That's how you make this crowd stand on its feet. Shoulders down.
And he's in there trying to get something going for his partner. And there's the count. With all of Xavier Woods' knowledge and talent in the ring, it should not surprise anyone that he's so innovative offensively, he has two finishing moves. The honor roll is an amazing forward flip that ends with a clothesline, and the Into the Woods can rip a shoulder right out of its socket.
Incredible move by Xavier Woods.
What a finishing move.
The shoulders are down.
Looking good now.
And the ref starts to count. Cole, what's he got in mind?
A crippling slam to the mat.
Well executed offense. Right now the momentum is with Big E, and who knows when it'll stop.
Jerry, earlier you described the awesome finishing moves that Xavier Woods has utilized here in WWE. Both the honor roll and Into the Woods display Xavier's proficiency with acrobatic assaults and those that attack an opponent's specific body part.
Well, they absolutely do, Michael. And both are equally impressive. Xavier's won many a match with both maneuvers. And since he can get his hip-hop keto on opponents of all sizes, it means no one's exempt from Xavier's wrath.
Big E into the cover. Star ensemble in the ring right now. Six of WWE's most successful competitors for sure. How's he getting away with this is beyond me. Rusev's getting ready here. Ladies and gentlemen, we start looking. There's the accolade. The end is near.
Yeah, you're never the same after that accolade is applied.
The referee getting involved now.
How much damage did that do?
A lot from the looks of it.
Just making his presence felt there.
Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
Not so fast. Big E escaped certain doom there.
Yeah, muscles and a great mind. Big E might just be the total package.
Let me tell you something, Cole. Big E has the type of smash-mouth offense that makes a WWE superstar think twice about signing a contract to go up against him. That's when you know someone's a force to be reckoned with. And that's Big E. You can actually see the ring shake after Big E hits one of his moves.
Great job by the official here tonight. I don't know how he's managed to keep somebody larger than life. But shoulders down, is it enough?
This may be it.
A wild overhead punch wreaking havoc in here.
No kidding, that shot came out of nowhere.
The key to avoid that.
Big E's moves, King, are designed to annihilate opponents, and if he chooses, can end a match in expedient fashion. Cover here. There can only be one top dog here in the WWE, and a win here will go a long way in solidifying one of these guys' claims of being the best. Shoulders down, is it enough?
It may be.
Oh, wow. We're looking at complete domination here.
Oh, wait, nice reversal. He makes the tag.
And he has to make a tag to his fresh partner.
Kofi Kingston is really going to town right now.
A major moment in the career of the Celtic Warrior Sheamus was winning the 2012 Royal Rumble. Sheamus was the 22nd superstar to enter the Rumble, and after more than 21 minutes, eliminated Chris Jericho. Sheamus punched his ticket to a championship match at WrestleMania 28, and well, we all know what happened then.
Yeah, Michael, I remember we called that Royal Rumble together, and it appears to cover.
There's the switch. He's got to be vigilant about not taking any more damage to the neck. Makes the cover.
And the ref starts to count.
Winning the 2012 Royal Rumble, which was the 25th Royal Rumble, was a major achievement in Sheamus' career. It's a special kind of accolade to be able to say you won the Royal Rumble. When Sheamus eliminated Chris Jericho, that should have been the warning that he was going to WrestleMania to make history.
Kofi nails the double leg drop.
This could do it.
Maybe it.
Making a statement here.
The referee getting involved now.
Remember, momentum in WWE can turn on a dime.
And leave you some change. Cole, Sheamus was ferocious the night of the Rumble. And what was also impressive about his
going for the cover. I'm having a hard time figuring out what they're going to do next.
Me too. I've given up even trying to figure out what they're going to do next. I'm just sitting back watching and enjoying.
Bad news, Barrett's flying away here with an awesome assault, and we got a bird's eye view. This is something we all know, but it's
What an all-star ensemble in the ring right now. Six of WWE's most successful competitors for sure. And Kofi Kingston makes him pay in the worst way on that exchange. Can he do it here?
This may be it.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And here's just some of the action we saw during the match.
Nice teamwork by these three to pick up the win.
Now that's having a game plan and...